Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, this morning we ascribe the glory, the honor that is due your holy name. We thank you, Lord, because you are a good God. You watch over your word to perform in our lives day in and day out. You have been mindful of each and every one of us. You have kept us. You have preserved us. You have secured us under your wings. And you are the God that daily loads us with benefits and heals all our diseases and forgives all our iniquities. Therefore, Father, this morning we say thank you. We bless your holy name. We are in your presence once again, Lord, to receive from you, to fellowship and to have communion with you. Lord, speak to our hearts this morning. Give each and every one of us a hearing ear and a hearing heart to be receptive to your word. And Father, empower us and increase us to be doers of your word throughout this day in the name of your Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, for this privilege once more. We bless your holy name for it. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Another beautiful day, another day in the presence of the living God. Let's go before him this morning as we lift up our voices with a heart full of appreciation as we sing to his glory this morning. In Jesus' name.
We will worship the Lamb.
Loving, loving, loving our King. up your voice tonight and declare,
you are God alone.
Yes, you are.
from before time began.
You are.
You are on your throne. You are God alone. And right now, and right
now. You are God.
Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. He is God by himself alone. That is why he's called the Most High God. Hallelujah. Let's go into our general prayers for this morning. Of the Uchina will be leading us in that.
Good morning, saints. We're going to pray for the welfare of our family today. We're going to be praying for the welfare of our family. Glory be to God. Father, we thank you for this opportunity to come to your presence. Thank you. We ask that everyone be blessed this morning in Jesus' mighty name. Our first prayer, we're going to give thanks to God. Give thanks unto the Lord this morning for his faithfulness to you and your family. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we call upon your name. Thank you that you are God. We want to give you thanks unto you this morning, thus, Lord, for your faithfulness to me and my family, O Lord. We give you praise. We honor you. Thank you, Lord, that you have made a way where there is no way. We give you thanks. Psalm 175, verse 1 said, give thanks unto the Lord. Give thanks unto the Lord. Oh, Lord, we give you thanks this morning. We give you thanks for the things you have done, for the wonderful things you have done for our family, for the life that you have given us, for this day, for being able to come into this day. Your faithfulness endures forever. Give thanks for the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever. Father, we want to give you thanks for your faithfulness over me and my family. Thank you, Lord, this morning. For you have done great things, marvelous things that is uncountable that you have done for our family. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for our faithfulness. Thank you for your faithfulness, O Lord. Your mercy endures forever. In Jesus' mighty name. Our next prayer, let's. Father, in the name of Jesus, we plead the cause of my family and fight against those that fight against our peace and enlargement, thereby increasing our peace and establish rest for us on every side. Father, let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we give you praise. I want to ask this morning to plead the cause of our family. As you said in Psalm 35, O Lord, that you contend, O Lord, with those that contend with me. Fight against those who fight against me. Take up your shield, O Lord. Take up your shield, O Lord, and armor, and arise and come to my aid, and brandish your spear and javelin against those who pursue me, O Lord. Father, O Lord, this morning, in the name of Jesus, we plead the cause of my family. We plead the cause of my family and fight against those who fight against our peace, who fight against our enlargement, oh, thereby increasing our peace, O Lord, and establish rest for us on every side in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we ask you today, brandish your spear against our enemies. Brandish your spear and javelin against those who pursue me, O Lord. And I say to you, you are my salvation, O Lord. You are my salvation, O Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, save me and my family against this evil, against this enemy that fight against us, against those that fight against our peace. Father, O Lord, take up your shield. Take up your shield and buckle. Take up your shield and buckle and armor. And come, O Lord, come to my aid. Help me, Lord. We plead the cause of my family. Fight against those that fight against me in my mighty name of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name. And this prayer, Father, in the name of Jesus, I decree in the name of Jesus that every contrary situation in the lives of any members of my family comes under your judgment today. Oh, Father, in the name of
Jesus. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I decree and declare that in the name of Jesus, that every contrary situation in the lives of any members of my family comes under your judgment, under your divine judgment today. Oh, Father, we call upon your name. You are God. I ask you this morning, oh Lord, as I decree and declare. You said you shall decree a thing and it shall come, it shall be established, and the light shall shine on your ways. Father, in the name of Jesus, I decree today, in the name of Jesus, that every contrary situation against any member of my family, against the lives of any member of my family, Father, oh Lord, we come at your divine judgment. Let your divine judgment, let that judgment be against them today in the mighty name of Jesus. Let them come under your divine judgment in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I decree and declare, oh Lord, you are my God. I call upon your name this morning. I decree in the name of Jesus, every contrary situation against any member of my family, oh Father, I call upon your name. You are my God. Father, oh Lord, help me, Lord, as we decree and declare, oh Lord, every contrary situation in the lives of any member of my family, oh Lord, comes under your divine judgment today in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we call upon your name. We call upon your name. You are God, El Shaddai, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Our next prayer, Father, in the name of Jesus, we call upon your name. By and by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, roll away our reproach. Roll away our reproach and wipe away our tears as a family and establish our prosperity in the land of the living. In the mighty name of Jesus, let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, roll away our reproach. Roll away our reproach. You said that today, that you roll away our reproach from us, from Egypt, and take away, wipe away our tears. Oh, Father, in the name of Jesus, as I call upon your name this morning, by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, roll away our reproach and wipe away our tears. Wipe away our secret tears as a family and establish our prosperity in the land of the living in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, in the name of Jesus, as we call upon your name this morning, roll away our reproach. Roll away our reproach. Oh, Father, in the name of Jesus, roll away our reproach. By the anointing of the Spirit, roll away our reproach. Wipe away our secret tears. Our secret tears, oh Lord, weeping may endure through the night, but joy comes in the morning. Oh, Father, wipe away our tears, oh Lord. Wipe away our tears as a family and establish us, oh Lord. And establish us, oh Lord. As you said in your word, and Isaiah 49, even the terrible, can the terrible be delivered? Oh, Father, we call upon your name. It is said in your word, you contend with those that contend with us, and we will have our peace. Father, this morning, in the name of Jesus, thank you. Roll away our reproach and wipe away our tears in Jesus' mighty name. Our next prayer, Father, in the name of Jesus, by the light of the Holy Spirit, let the yoke of the ignorance be destroyed from every member of my family, and the light of the gospel of Jesus Christ will shine in their hearts in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, by the light of the Holy Spirit, let the yoke of ignorance be destroyed. Let the yoke of ignorance be destroyed from every member of my family, and that the light of the gospel of Jesus Christ will shine in their hearts, oh Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, in the name of Jesus, in the light of the Holy Spirit. Oh, Father, let the yoke of ignorance be destroyed. Let it be destroyed from every member of my family. Let it be taken away, oh Lord, by the power of the Holy Spirit. And let the light of the gospel, let the light of the gospel, oh Lord, be shine will shine on their hearts. Let the guide of the gospel of Jesus Christ, let it shine on their hearts, O Lord, bringing them to salvation. Oh, Father, oh, Lord, you are their light and my salvation. You are my light and my salvation. Oh, Father, in the name of Jesus, the Lord is my light and my salvation. This morning, oh, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, by the light of the Holy Spirit, let the yoke of the ignorance be destroyed. Let your light shine upon every member of my family. Let that light shine, oh, Lord. The light of the gospel of Jesus Christ will shine in their hearts and bring them to salvation. Oh, Father, oh, Lord, as I pray this morning, let the light shine in their hearts. Let the light shine, oh, Lord. Let that yoke be destroyed by the name, in the name of Jesus, Father. Our next prayer, Father, in the name of Jesus, be a wall of fire round about my family and be the glory in our midst that nothing will be able to hurt us. Henceforth, in Jesus' mighty name. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, oh Lord, as we call upon your name, be a wall of fire around my family. Be a wall of fire around my family, oh Lord. Be that glory in their midst. Establish your glory in the midst of my family. Let there be nothing that will be able to hurt us. Let nothing that will be able to hurt us henceforth in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, be the wall of my family. Be the wall in my family. Be the wall of fire round about my family. And be the glory in our midst. Nothing will be able to hurt us. Nothing will be able to hurt us, oh Lord. Henceforth, in the mighty name of Jesus, oh Father, we call upon your name. Be the wall, oh Lord, the wall of fire around my family. Burn every chap of the enemy that is against us, oh Lord. Be the glory in our midst. Be the glory in our midst, oh Lord, that nothing will be able to hurt us. Nothing. We'll be able to hold us henceforth in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, in the name of Jesus, as we call upon your name, as we call upon your name, fight those who fight against us. Fight those who fight against us, oh Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, fight those who fight against us. He said in your word, yes, the captive will be taken away from the warrior and the plunder retrieved from the henceforth. You will contend with those who contend with my family and the children, and your children will be saved in the name of Jesus. Father, this morning, as we call upon your name, be the wall of fire around my family. Protect us from evil people in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Our next prayer, Father, in the name of Jesus, empower every member of my family to walk in the light of your word, thereby being victorious in the affairs of my lives in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, in the name of Jesus, as we call upon your name, empower us, O Lord. Empower us by your spirit. Empower us by your spirit. Empower every member of my family to walk in the light of your word, to walk in the light of your word, thereby being victorious in the affairs of our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we thank you. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Father, as we call upon your name, O Lord, empower every member of my family to walk in the light of your gospel. Strengthen us in our inner mind. Strengthen us in our inner mind. Help us to walk in the light of your word, thereby being victorious in the affairs of our life in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, amen. This morning, as we call upon your name, you are the great I am. In the name of Jesus, empower every member of my family to walk in the light of your word, to walk in the light of your word, thereby helping us, O Lord, being victorious. Let us be victorious in the affairs of our lives, in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, as you said in your word, Father, O Lord, empower us to walk. Fill us with your power. Fill us with your power, O Lord. Fill us with your power, O Lord, as you said in your word. Can the plunder be taken away from the warriors or the captive be rescued? Father, O Lord, empower us. Empower us, O Lord, according to your word, in Jesus' mighty name. Finally, brethren, Father, in the name of Jesus, you said, I shall be saved with my household. Therefore, ignite the revival fire of the gospel of Jesus Christ in my family, delivering the oppressed and saving the lost among us by your spirit, in Jesus' mighty name. Let's pray. Finally, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, as you said in your word. You said also, I shall be saved and my family. For me and my household, you shall be saved. You said, believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, and you and your family will be saved. Therefore, O Lord, ignite the revival fire, O Lord. Ignite the revival fire of the gospel of Jesus Christ in my family, delivering the oppressed, saving the lost among us by your spirit. By your spirit, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, O Lord, I ask, O Lord, ignite that revival fire. Therefore, O Lord, save me with my household. Save me with my household, therefore. Ignite the revival fire, O Lord, in the gospel of the gospel of Jesus Christ in my family. O Father, delivering the oppressed, O Lord, and saving the lost among us by your spirit in the mighty name of Jesus. O Father, finally, thank you, O Lord, for answered prayers. Father, as you have saved my family, thank you, O Lord, for saving my family. Therefore, O Lord, ignite the revival fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for loving us in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We're going to our scripture reading for this morning. We are reading from the book of Isaiah chapter 61 from verse 1 to 11. Isaiah 61 from verse 1 to 11. Sister Kehinde will read for us this morning.
Good morning, everyone. May God hear our prayers and all our supplications in Jesus' name. I'm reading Isaiah 61, 1 to 11. I'm reading from the King James Version. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord hath anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He hath sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captive, and the opening of the prison to them that are bound, to proclaim the acceptable years of the Lord, and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all that mourns, to appoint unto them, that mourns in Zion, to give unto them beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heavenness, that they might be called the trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that he might be glorified. And they shall build the old wastes, they shall rise up the former desolation, and they shall repair the waste cities and desolation of many generations. And strangers shall stand and feed your flock, and the sons of the alien shall be your plowmen and your vine dressers. But ye shall be named the priests of the Lord, men shall call you the ministers of our God. Ye shall eat the riches of the Gentiles, and in thy glory shall ye boast yourself. Verse 7. For your shame ye shall have double, and for confusion ye shall rejoice in the portions, in their portions. Therefore, in their land ye shall possess the double. Everlasting joy shall be unto you. For I, Lord, love judgment. I hate robbery for burnt offering. And I will direct thy work in truth. And I will make an everlasting covenant with them. And their seed shall be known amongst Gentiles. And their offspring shall amongst the people. All that sees them shall acknowledge them, that they are the seed which the Lord had blessed. 10, I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. Oh my God. In the Lord, my soul shall rejoice in my God, for he hath clothed me with the garment of salvation. He hath covered me with the robe of righteousness. Excuse me, as a bride decketh himself with ornaments and as a bride, as a bridegroom decketh himself with ornaments and as a bride adoreth herself with jewels. For as the earth bringeth forth her bud, and as the garden causeth the things that are sown in it to spring forth, shall the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to spring forth before all the nations. Thank the Lord for the reading of the Bible.
Hallelujah. He says, and all that see them shall acknowledge that these are the people that God has blessed. All that see them shall acknowledge them. Hallelujah. Welcome again to this platform this morning. I believe God has answered your prayers already. I'm still on the subject of divine intervention. And as much as I want to say, oh God, step into the affairs of their life and turn their story, I believe I will still do that by Friday when we get there. But there are things we just need to know and work with. Jeremiah chapter 8, verse 20. He said, the harvest is past. The summer is ended. But we are not saved. What's going on here? In fact, if you read it earlier, you will see that they are bothered. God, what's going on? We are your children now. We pray tongues. We fast. We do this. But what's going on? We don't get what we are looking for. And then he replied in verse 21. He said, look, for the heart of the daughter of my people are my heart. I'm black. Astonishment has taken hold of me. Is there no balm in Gilead? Is there no physician there? Why then is not the health of the daughter of my people recovered? That is to say, what's going on with you too? I feel what you feel. I'm hurt that you are hurt. But the provisions are there. Why are you still sick? The balm is there. The physician, the prescriptions are there. That is actually how it is with God. Even when it comes to the subject of divine intervention, we also must be correctly positioned for divine intervention, just as it is with every other thing, with God. He said, we have not an high priest which cannot be touched with the feelings of our infirmities. He can be touched. He's touched with it because he went through it all. Start with it. Please understand that you must be correctly positioned. There is where you must be, not necessarily geographically, there's where you must be for God to reach you. And like I said yesterday, it began with your identity with Him, knowing who you are. You remember the prodigal son? Even having done all that he did, he worked with certain understanding. He said, excuse me, what's going on here? Even in my father's house, slaves are better than me. He still knew that. He said, I'm going back to my father. I will tell him this, I will tell him that. But you see, that's where it all comes from. The father's heart was after him, but the father didn't go pick him. He had to come. Did Jesus not say, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest? So we need to understand this so that we are correctly positioned for divine intervention. I started by saying it, as a child of God, you are ordained to give value. And that's what the Isaiah we read here is saying to us. He said, to comfort all my mourn. But then verse 3, he said, to appoint unto them that mourn in Zion, as the church, to give unto them beauty for ashes. God will change your story. The oil of joy for mourning, it will terminate your sorrows. The garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they might be called. That's a change. That's a transformation. And I always tell people, the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ is a gospel of change. If it's not changing you, you never had it. You're going to church, whichever church you go, but if it's not changing you, no. The gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ is a gospel of change. To appoint unto them that money, that to give unto them. So that is what it gives you. Beautiful ashes. The oil of joy for mourning. The garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. That they might be called. There's a change of name. There's a change of story. The trees of righteousness. Just any name. The planting of the Lord, that God himself might be glorified. And these ones who are now redeemed, who are now transformed, who are now changed, will go forth and begin to build the old ways. They shall raise up the former desolations. They shall repair the wasted. That's why I said yesterday, you don't carry a consumer mentality. You carry a reformer's mentality, a giver's mentality. Because that's who you are. That's what we are ordained for. To build. To reform, to repair. Glory to God. We are repairers, not destroyers. We are builders, not destroyers. The day there is talking about us, as he says, but ye shall be named the priests of the Lord. Men shall call you the ministers of our God. And you shall heap, as a result of that, the riches of the Gentiles. So you see, there is who you are, and there is what you are ordained for, to which, when you are correctly positioned, you enjoy divine intervention. Men shall call you, he says. Because they will see that, just like it was the word Christian was a man word, they saw it, they saw the change, they saw the way they were operating, they saw, oh, these ones are like Christ. And as they were Christians, men shall call you because they've seen the change. The gospel of salvation commands empowerment to the believer to change lives, to be a builder, to be a restorer. Glory to God. Remember, we said this yesterday. God blesses you so that you can be a blessing. Your story is changing from today. We need to carry that, have that understanding, so that we are correctly positioned. Remember, when Saul met with Samuel in the book of 1 Samuel, when he met with Samuel, and he was anointed. 1 Samuel chapter 10 and verse 6, he said, the Spirit of the Lord will come upon thee, and you shall prophesy with them, and shall be turned into another man. Have you read the New Testament? They're now new creatures in Christ. That's a concept. If there must be a change, shall be turned into another man. And when you are turned, this new man that you are, he said, let it be that you do as occasion serves you. Because this new man is empowered. This new man is enthroned. This new man is in charge. And that's who you are. That's what salvation makes you. Shall be turned into another man. Because the Spirit of the Lord comes upon you in our own, is residing in us. It's time to pick your pictures from scriptures. See who you are. And position yourself correctly for God to intervene. Glory to God. Glory to God. God begins from your heart. Because where your heart is where God will meet you. My bishop will say, if it's in your heart, God will put it in your hand. God said to David that it was in your heart you do well. Where is your heart? Is it the one crying that all hope is lost? Or the one that is focused on God, that I know who I am, I know who my God is? My story must change. And when you get focused on that, you begin to experience that change of story that your heart craves for. Because God don't respond to everyone, no. He responds to those who are correctly positioned with him. And redemption does that for you. Redemption does that for you. He said, now are we the sons of God. He does not yet appear. We don't look it, but we know when we see him, we'll be like him. But to as many as received him, to them gave him power to become the sons of God. I say this again in closing, we'll continue tomorrow. If the gospel of Jesus that you claim you received has not changed you and it's not changing you, I'm not sure you had it, because it's a gospel of change. It's a gospel of divine empowerment. That's what the gospel is. It makes another man out of you, an empowered man. A man that does as occasion serving. That means he's in charge. Begin to see yourself in the light of this henceforth, so that the power of God will flow through you. The glory of God will be seen upon you. And like that scripture we just read say, that they that see them shall acknowledge them, that these are the seed which the Lord has blessed. It's time you be acknowledged as the seed that the Lord has blessed. As the seed, as one that God has blessed. I'm sure by the time we'll be getting to Friday, it will become clearer to you and you will be in a position to receive. You are the seed that God has blessed. The blessing must speak. But it begins with this change. As for no, we no more again after the flesh. And you have to start seeing yourself that way. It's time to go before the Lord again this morning and call upon him face to face. And make your request known to him. You have saved me. Now help me to live this life with good understanding of who I am, with good understanding of what you have procured for me. With a good understanding of whom you have made me, that I may be able to walk rightly in the power of the gospel. Like Paul said, when I come unto you, I will come in the fullness of the blessings of the gospel. The gospel is not just a religious identity. No. It's an identity with God that positions you correctly to manifest his power and his grace. Let's go before the Lord this morning. Whatever your heart desires to present to him, to say to him, to communicate to him, it's over to you. We'll be back together shortly. Jesus is Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. May the Lord of heaven hear you. And in hearing, respond speedily to you. In the name of Jesus. Please understand that God said, he said, my hand is not short that I can reach you. But there's something that has taken you far. That's why we talk of correct positioning. Take advantage of the environment you are in. And putting your life in order that God can reach you speedily. You know, he said in his word, before they call, I will answer. While they are speaking, I will perform. Yet there are those that he said, you will call and I will not listen to it. So it comes down to you being correctly positioned with God. And this time, the favor of the Lord will answer for you. It's a sorrow and mourning may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. You are coming out of that crisis. You are coming out of that pain. Like that. Because you are in his presence. When you get there, every contrary thing drops, consumed by his fire. You never live the same. So I'm persuaded you are not leaving this platform the same this morning. That is definite. That effort you made to come into his presence is all that it will take to free you from every affliction. Glory to God. Thank God for another day in his presence this morning. He said, day by day, he wakeneth my ear to hear as the land. And as he wakens, he don't be rebellious. Because his word of instruction, his word of direction comes to you daily. And it's coming to you again today. Receive it and walk in it. That's all it takes. Everybody was running away because there was famine. But that word came to Isaac. No, don't go down to Gera. Stay here. And I will be with you there. And it prospered there. That word that you need to hear that takes taking you to where you should be, what you should do, is coming to you as I'm speaking. Because we are before him. Not before Pastor Tunji, for God's sake. You are before the Lord. And his voice is locating you. His presence is draining off all that should not be in your body. So strangers shall hear my voice, and they shall fade away in their closed places. That's your story this morning. I'm telling you, before today is over, you will discover that they have left your body. It's gone out. Because the divine presence is being infused, and all that is going out. Staying in his presence, light and darkness cannot cohabit. So all that is going off you in the name of Jesus. I know that for a certainty. Glory to God. Remember, I'm still saying it, 31st of this month is our testimony day. I'm still expecting to have your testimonies sent. Text them to me or by email. You always have the address posted. 918-409-3169 or kcaidenver, one word, kcaidenver@gmail.com. And that would be, we want to celebrate. It's just to celebrate the doings of God. And like I said, encounters on this platform. Encounters through this platform. And we're going to celebrate it together. We don't want to say, okay, anybody who has testimony, no, we don't do that. This is time-constrained program. So you will have it in, we collate. You still share it, but I will collate it and monitor it. Glory to God. It's thank God for those who are, I see that some people are joining for the first time today. The same glory and beauty that we've been enjoying goes with you also. But the consistency and the fervency with which we do is what keeps the blessing going. So let's keep inviting our friends and colleagues, and family and co-workers, wherever, to come and encounter the glory of the Lord. Have a change of story. Be refreshed by the hand of God through this platform. And as you keep bringing them, God will keep increasing you in your life and blessing you in their life and multiplying you in your life in the name of Jesus. Tomorrow is another day because it runs Monday through Friday. We'll be back here at 5 a.m. Mountain Time and continue on correct positioning for divine intervention. I think I'm going to go in the realm of the subject of faith tomorrow. Jesus is Lord. Father, we thank you this morning. We bless your name. Let your goodness go with everyone. That goodness you purchased, procured by the blood, let it go with everyone hearing me this morning. As you move, turning their trials into testimonies. As you move, displaying them to their world as the seed that the Lord has blessed. Let that blessing speak openly, continually in these lives. In the name of Jesus, your today is blessed. Go in peace. Jesus is Lord. Let's share the goodness together. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. God bless you. See you tomorrow. Jesus is Lord.